Hello friends, once again welcome back to the Core Chemical Engineering channel. So today in this tutorial I'll tell you about how to calculate the pressure drop across the packed beds. Okay, so in the previous tutorial I have told you about drag and drag coefficient from the chapter flow past immersed bodies. Okay, so you can see it here, flow through beds of solid. If there is a flow through the beds of solid, then how you can calculate the pressure drop, okay, through that. So you can see the examples here: filtration, ion exchange, chromatography, mass transfer operations, absorption, distillation or drying. In all these cases, liquid or gases flow through beds of solid particles. Okay, so in this tutorial our sole objective is to calculate the pressure drop through a bed of solid. Okay, so as we know, pressure drop through a weight of solids are based on estimates of total drag on the solid boundaries of the tortuous channels through the bed particles. Okay, so you can see it here. Okay, this is how your, you know, packings, like packed beds packings, okay, will be packed in the any column. Okay, and fluid will be flowing like this in the upward direction. This is like just like a diagram we are taking as an example. Now here flow will be like this, flow can go like this, like this, like this. Okay, now flow can take the path like this. Okay, so across this bed, okay, this bed we are assuming, this side as bed, we are going to calculate the pressure drop. But for the calculation of pressure drop, we are considering the following assumptions. Okay, the solid particles are packed at a random with no preferred orientation, so this is the original case. Okay, now all the particles are of same size and shape, so we are assuming that all the particles are of same size and shape, which is actually not true at all. Now, but we are taking it as an assumption. There is no rough surface. Obviously there will be rough surface, we can't get 100% smooth surface. Okay, fourth, actual weight is replaced by the weight containing straight parallel channels of constant cross section. So the actual weight, you can see, it is replaced by bead containing straight parallel channels like this. This is straight parallel channels. So this is the empty space through which now fluid will flow. Okay, and these beds are, actual bed are being replaced by these channels 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, actual weight is replaced by bead containing straight parallel channels of constant cross section. Now the fifth assumption is the internal porosity of particle is neglected. So internal, the particles which are arranged in this packed bed, the internal porosity of the particles are neglected. Okay, now we'll see one more thing. What is specific packing here? So in unit volume, how much packing area is there is called specific packing, surface area divided by unit volume. Okay, now we'll go for the derivation part. So before that, we need to know about sphericity. Okay, and this is very important with respect to the GATE exam. So sphericity is defined as surface to volume ratio of spherical particle divided by surface to volume ratio of a given particle nominal diameter dp. Okay, so the formula is equal to phi is equal to 6 by dp divided by sp by vp. okay, sp is your surface area of particle, vp is the volume of the particle here, 6 by dp, dp is the diameter of the particle. So you can see that this derivation, this value you can get it from here. Okay, from the definition you can see it here, it is defined as the surface to volume ratio of a spherical particle. So surface area, as you know, would be your pi dp square. Okay, divided by 4 by 3 pi dp cube by 8. Okay, now whole divided by surface area to volume ratio sp by vp. Okay, now if you divide this value, okay, you will get 6 by dp divided by sp by bp. okay, so this is your correct answer for calculation of sphericity. Okay, now phi is equal to 1. Okay, so both will be same. If you are going to calculate the for a sphere, you are comparing with the sphere only, so obviously it will be same. Now the next thing that we need to know is equivalent diameter, because these are the terms that we are going to use while the calculation of pressure drop. So equivalent diameter, it is diameter of a sphere having the same volume as the given particle. Okay, so for a cube, consider side is having s, that cube is having side s. Okay, so volume of the sphere has been known, 4.3 pi r cube is equivalent to pi d cube by 6. Okay, is equal to s cube. Now we'll get dp in terms of side. Okay, side of square, 6 by pi raised to the power 1 by 3 into s. Now we have to calculate the sphericity. Now phi is equal to 6 by dp divided by sp by vp. So 6 divided by dp, dp value we have calculated in the terms of side. Okay, so let's put this value. Now sp is your 6s square divided by volume, vp is your s cube. Just if you solve this whole thing, okay, term, you will get pi by 6 raised to power 1 by 3. Now the value of phi is 0.8059. this is for cube. Sometimes they give in the gate exam, they ask just simply what is the sphericity of cube, okay, having side s, okay, or having side 5 centimeter unit. Okay, so that dimension doesn't matter, your sphericity will be same. Okay, phi is equal to 0.8059. now the sphericity of other objects like ideal torus is 0.896, ideal cylinder is 0.874, hemisphere is 0.840. now after that comes 0.8059, after that ideal cone 0.794. so you must remember the order, okay, order of increasing sphericity or decreasing sphericity with respect to the gate exam, because sometimes they give all this and they just ask the order of sphericity in the gate exam. So if you are going to calculate for each and everything like ideal cylinder, a hemisphere, then it is going to take your time. So in order to avoid the wastage of time, you must remember this at least for cylinder, hemisphere and cube and ideal cone, you must remember. Now let's go for the pressure drop calculation part. Okay, so you can see it here, wattage or porosity or void fraction. So we have to calculate first. So epsilon is your wattage is equal to volume of wires divided by total volume. Total volume is particle volume plus void. Okay, so fraction of solid is your 1 minus epsilon void is your, you will get the fraction of solid side. Now surface area of n channel is equal to surface area of particle, obviously. So as we know, the surface area of n channel is equal to pi d equivalent into l, right? You'll get pi d equivalent into l. This is your d equivalent diameter through which fluid is going to flow. Okay, equivalent diameter, pi d equivalent into l. L is the length of the bed. Okay, so this is for one channel. If you multiply it with n, you will get the surface area of n channel. Now is equal to sp by vp into, well, this is the volume of solid. Epsilon is for void. Now 1 minus epsilon is fraction of solid. Okay, so s naught into l is the total volume of solid. Okay, so this is the equation 1. Now see the relation, volume of n channel is equal to volume of voids, as we know. So again here pi r square h, as we know the volume of any cylinder, okay, cylindrical form. Okay, now so pi by 4 d equivalent square into l is your volume of n one channel into n is correspond to volume of n channel. So is equal to s naught l into epsilon. So epsilon is your void. Okay, so if you divide equation 2 by equation 1 and if you solve it, we'll get d equivalent value is equal to 4 into epsilon divided by 1 minus epsilon in bracket into vp by sp. Okay, so as we know, phi is equal to 6 by dp divided by sp by vp. So bp by sp, from here we can get phi dp divided by 6. So let's put this value here. So if you put this value vp by sp from here to here, we'll get the value of d equivalent is equal to 4 into epsilon divided by 1 minus epsilon into phi dp divided by 6. So if you solve it, to divide both by 2, okay, so 2 here, 3 comes here. So d equivalent equal to 2 by 3 into phi dp into epsilon divided by 1 minus epsilon. So this is the equivalent diameter, okay, for the channel, calculation of equivalent diameter. Now comes the velocity through weight is equal to V, okay. So V will equal to V naught, okay. So V naught is the initial approach velocity. Now the velocity that will flow into the channel, so area here gets decreased, okay. So anyway, pressure will, area, if area gets decreased, then your velocity will increase, right? So V is equal to greater than V naught. So superficial velocity or impacted or velocity V naught. So SV, as we know, according to continuity equation, A1, V1, A, area into velocity at one point is equal to A2 into V2, okay. At area at other point into velocity. So similarly, the here is the relation, S into V is equal to S0 into V0. S is cross-section area of channel, S0 is cross-section area of impacted tower. So if you are taking cross-section of area of impacted tower, then V0 is the velocity here. If you are taking cross-section area S here only, cross-section area of channel, okay. If you are taking as S, then we need to consider volume with respect to the S, okay. Velocity with respect to S. So V is equal to S0 divided by S into V0. So as we know, volume of channel, okay. So volume of channel S into L is equal to S into L into epsilon. Epsilon is your impacted part. So it becomes the volume of the channel. So L gets cancelled. So S0 divided by S equal to 1 by epsilon. So if you put the value of S here, you will get V equal to V0 divided by epsilon is equal to the same. V naught by epsilon, okay. So for a small Reynolds number, as we know, delta P by L is equal to 32 mu V divided by D equivalent square, okay. So D equivalent value, we had calculated it here, okay. D equivalent is equal to 2 by 3 into 5 into dP into epsilon divided by 1 minus epsilon. Now you have to put this D equivalent value in this equation here, okay. In the Hausdorff-Posley equation, when your Reynolds number is less than 1, okay, then only this relation is valid. So put the value of D equivalent here. If you put the value of D equivalent here, 4 square, you will get the final value, this delta P by L is equal to 72 mu lambda 1 V naught into 1 minus epsilon whole square divided by 5 square dP square into epsilon cube, okay, epsilon cube. So this is called Kozni-Karman equation when Reynolds, Kozni-Karman equation, and this equation is valid when Reynolds number is less than 1, because for this small, for a small Reynolds number only, this relation Hausdorff-Posley equation is valid, okay. Now, so this is your relation, delta P by L is equal to 150 now. So lambda 1, the value we have taken from the experiment, we got that this value, okay, lambda 1 into 72 is equal to, into 72 value is equal to your 150, okay. So delta P by L is equal to 150 mu B naught into 1 minus epsilon square divided by 5 square dP square into epsilon cube. So this is the formula relation for Kozni-Karman equation for Reynolds number less than 1, okay. So this one is very, very important. You must remember, sometimes they ask the question in the gate exam directly based on this formula, okay. Now, as we know, the for turbulent case, okay, delta P by L is equal to 4F, okay, 4F rho V square by 2D equivalent. Delta P by L is equal to 4F rho V square by 2 into D equivalent here, okay. Now D equivalent value, again we need to put it here. If you put, now if you put the value of D equivalent, okay, D equivalent value 2 by 3 phi into dP into epsilon divided by 1 minus epsilon. If you solve it, you will get this value, okay. Delta P by L is equal to 3F rho V naught square into 1 minus epsilon divided by 5 dP into epsilon cube, okay. So delta P by L is equal to 3F lambda 2 into rho V naught square into 1 minus epsilon divided by 5 dP epsilon cube. So 3F lambda 2, okay. Okay, lambda 2 we are taking as constant, like one constant that that actually makes both the terms, right, left hand and right hand, equal, okay. So 3F lambda 2 value from the experiment we have gotten 1.75. so if you put this value, we'll get delta P by L is equal to 1.75 into rho V naught square into 1 minus epsilon divided by 5 dP into epsilon cube. So this relation is called as Burke-Plumber equation, and that is valid for Reynolds number greater than 1000, okay. So this is called kinetic loss, okay, and this one is called viscous loss. Sometimes in the gate exam they are asked, which term is viscous loss and which term is kinetic loss. You must remember. Okay. Now for entire range of Reynolds number, you have to add both the kinetic and viscous loss. Okay. So if you add it, you will get this whole term. Okay. So this is question is called as argon equation. So delta P by L is equal to 150 mu B naught into 1 minus epsilon square divided by 5 square dp square epsilon cube. This is your viscous loss plus 1.75 rho V naught square into 1 minus epsilon divided by 5 dp into epsilon cube. Okay. This is your kinetic loss. Okay. So if you add both the term, we'll get the pressure drop through the pipe bed of length L, okay, height L for the entire range of Reynolds number. Okay. So this is very important. So this equation covering entire range of flow rates and is obtained by assuming the viscous loss and kinetic energy losses are additive. Okay. So rearranging the equation. Okay. 1.75, keep the term here. Okay. And divide the whole term by this value. We'll get this relation. Okay. So from here, we'll get FV equal to 150 into 1 minus epsilon divided by 5 into Reynolds number of particle plus 1.75. Okay. So friction factor for this is called friction factor for the packed beds, right? So thereby from there we can calculate the power is equal to delta P into flow rate. Okay. So use of this equation is to calculate pressure drop, power requirement, surface area of particle, velocity for calculation of flow rate. Okay. So rho cannot be taken as constant. Use average rho to account for the shape and size of particle. Okay. So guys, this is all about the calculation of pressure drop through the packed beds. Okay. So guys, this is all about the pressure drop calculation across the packed beds. Okay. So you must remember this argon equation, and this argon equation is very, very important with respect to the gate exam. Guys, must remember this formula. Okay. Because you can't derive this formula during the gate exam. So this relation is very important. So guys, that's all for today's tutorial. So guys, if you do like this video, please do share and subscribe, and let me know into the comment section. Okay. If you want to know anything else apart from this tutorial, please do comment in the comment box. Okay. I'll definitely reply. Okay. Even if I can't reply there, I'll make the video and publish the full tutorial for your comments. So guys, thank you. Thank you so much for watching. Okay. So please do subscribe and share this channel. Thank you.